Biggest art thefts in history. Hey everyone, it's Alexa again. Welcome back to another video. Wouldn't it be amazing to own an original Van Gogh or Picasso? Many would agree. However, the chances of you or me ever owning an original are slim to none. Some feel this doesn't work for them and go to extra lengths to ensure they have one in their possession and they're willing to do whatever it takes. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. Easy come, easy go. The Mona Lisa took a little leave of absence from the Louvre in 1911. An amateur painter headed to the museum, set up his easel, looked up at the Mona Lisa which he was about to copy, and it wasn't there. 2 years were spent searching for the masterpiece. Guillaume Apollinaire and Pablo Picasso were all roped into the case. Then, 2 years later, a prominent art dealer in France received a call from Vincenzo Perugia, claiming to have the painting in his possession. Perugia was a former employee of the Louvre, and he had removed the painting from its frame and sauntered out of the museum with a priceless piece underneath his clothing. He served 6 months in jail for his crime. A real scream. A far more recent art heist took place in 2004 at a Norwegian art museum. Thieves stole two paintings, which doesn't seem like a big deal, except one of the paintings was Edvard Munch's Scream and Madonna. The value of the paintings is roughly $19 million. Poor security was blamed, as the pieces were simply hanging by wires on the walls. The robbery took place in broad daylight in front of visitors to the museum. Reports differ, but some suggest the robbers did draw out weapons when they raced out of the museum. The paintings were recovered 2 years later, but had suffered considerable damage. Fake it. Over the course of 2 years, a chief librarian at Gwangju Academy of Fine Arts dabbled in a little art. Between 2004 and 2006, he replaced 140 paintings with his own copies of them. Zhao Wan, a clearly talented artist, sold the pieces at auctions and made $6 million. When he was eventually caught, he was still in possession of $11 million of artwork. He defended himself and claims that this type of thievery is very common in the art community, and claims that other thieves had replaced his fakes with their own fakes. World's first. It's possible that this may have happened before 1473, but the first documented art heist was when a triptych, which is art created in three panels by Dutch painter Hans Memling, was stolen by Polish pirates. They took the piece to a cathedral in Poland, and today it's still part of the city's National Museum. A Van Gogh. Van Gogh's Poppy Flowers is worth around $55 million and is still missing in action. The painting is small, measuring just 25 by 21 inches. It was stolen from an Egyptian museum in 2010. On the day the painting was stolen, 36 of the museum's 43 security cameras were not working. It's not the first time the painting was stolen either. It was stolen in 1978 and recovered 10 years later in Kuwait. A little FYI, Van Gogh created 900 paintings within 10 years before he died at the age of 37. He only started painting at the age of 27. Lesson learned. Manchester's Whitworth Art Gallery got lucky when they had three expensive paintings stolen from them. Wait for it. The robbery occurred in 2003, and three works of art were taken. They were by Vincent van Gogh, Pablo Picasso, and Paul Gauguin. They were all recovered a few days later in a public restroom nearby. The media cleverly dubbed it the Louvre, and the paintings were rolled up inside a cardboard tube. Along with that, there was a note that read, "We did not intend to steal these paintings, just to highlight the woeful security." Cry your art out. To date, the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum heist is still the largest private property theft in American history. March 18, 1990, disguised as two policemen, thieves gained entrance into the museum, citing that they received a call regarding a noise disturbance. Once they gained access, they tied up the security guard and made off with 13 pieces of art, valued at $500 million. They stole works from Rembrandt, Vermeer, Manet, and Flink, as well as five Degas drawings. It took them 81 minutes and two trips to their Dodge Daytona to remove the precious artwork. None of these valuable pieces has ever been found, and there is still a $5 million reward for usable information about the artwork's whereabouts. Happy hunting. Follow your art. Our next crime scene is the Kunsthal Museum in Rotterdam, Netherlands, where seven paintings were stolen in 2012. Works from Picasso, Monet, De Haan, and Gauguin were all taken. The heist took less than 3 minutes, and one of the robbers threatened to sue the museum, stating that the robbery was far too easy. The four Romanians who took the artwork were fined 18 million euros. The location of the artwork, however, is still a mystery. Dutch media labeled it the theft of the century. Works of art. Sweden's National Museum also lost some significant pieces in 2000, which included two Renoirs and a Rembrandt. The theft was well executed. One robber threatened the security staff, another two grabbed the paintings, while more accomplices blew up empty cars around the city to distract the police. The robbers then jumped into a waiting speedboat and fled the scene. The value of the artwork was $45 million. One painting was recovered shortly thereafter, but it took another 5 years to find the other two pieces. One was found at the Copenhagen Hotel, and the other in Los Angeles. Gone, but not forgotten. It really is a hit or a miss when it comes to recovering stolen artwork. The Pigeon with Green Peas, a piece done by Picasso, was removed from the Modern Art Museum in Paris in 2010. The thief got spooked and he dumped the piece into a trash can. Sadly, garbage collectors do as they do and emptied the cans, and it's believed that the painting was destroyed. Art of Possible. If you'd like to solve crimes, you could try your luck with this one. View of Auvers-sur-Oise by Paul Cézanne was removed from the Ashmolean Museum in 2000. People were out in droves, celebrating the change from 1999 into 2000, except for two thieves, who were busy cutting a hole in the skylight of the museum. The painting was created between 1873 and 1875, and it has never been seen again. The value is £3 million, and where it is now is anyone's guess. Art Hotspot. Rusborough House used to belong to Sir Alfred Beit, a British Conservative Party politician who was known for his love of art. Since 1974, the Irish estate has been robbed 4 times. The IRA stole 19 paintings in 1974, worth around £8 million. The paintings were recovered at a rented cottage in Cork. The perpetrators were caught and sent to jail. Then again in 1986, when a Dublin gang took off with 18 paintings, valued at £30 million. 16 paintings were recovered, but 2 are still missing. Another 2 paintings were stolen in 2001 by 3 armed men with a value of £3 million. Both have been found. Within days of finding the 2 paintings, another 5 paintings were taken, and they were recovered in 2002. As pretty as a picture. The Sicilian Mafia stole Nativity with St. Francis and St. Lawrence, done by Italian Baroque master Caravaggio, with an estimated worth of $20 million. It was stolen from the Oratory of San Lorenzo in Palermo, Sicily in 1969. Thieves removed the large painting from its frame, and it's assumed they folded it as it was so large. Francesco Marino Mannoia confessed to stealing the piece in 1996, but it's never been recovered. The painting was reconstructed by computer, and it's sadly believed that the original was destroyed while it was being hidden in a barn. Paint by numbers. The Ghent altarpiece was painted by Flemish artists Hubert and Jan van Eyck, and it dates to the 15th century. It's a polyptych, meaning it's divided into sections, and was made for the Cathedral of St. Bavo in Ghent, Belgium. The work has had a tumultuous history, with both the French and the Germans stealing parts of it. After World War I, the artwork had all of its original components. All that changed in 1934, when thieves broke into the cathedral and removed the lower left panel. That has never been seen again. During World War II, a replica of the missing piece was painted, and it was done so perfectly that many believe it's the original, hiding in plain sight. No oil painting. The Van Gogh Museum is in the Netherlands, and it's a museum dedicated to, you guessed it, the works of Vincent van Gogh. It's also been the location of 2 different heists. In 1991, $500 million worth of paintings were stolen from the walls, but they were found within 30 minutes in a parked car outside. Despite that lucky find, it took a further 3 months to find the thieves. Another 2 paintings were stolen in 2002 and only found 14 years later. Octave Durham, one of the thieves, had to serve 25 months in prison for his involvement in the crime. Gone forever. The National Museum of Anthropology was an art thief's paradise in 1985, when 140 priceless works were removed on Christmas Eve. They took priceless pieces of Mayan and Aztec art. Only the best and most valuable pieces were taken, so it was agreed that the thieves had a strong knowledge of the artwork. 9 police guards were questioned, but none were charged. So far, only a few pieces have been recovered, and it's believed the rest has been sold to private collectors. Artful timing. Stephen Hahn was an American art dealer who opened the Stephen Hahn Madison Avenue Art Gallery. He had art stolen from his gallery in 1969, which included works by Cassatt, Monet, Pissarro, and Rouault. Ironically, he happened to be chatting to other art dealers about art theft at the exact time that $500,000 of his own artwork was stolen. State of the art. This was the largest art theft in Canada and took place in 1972, where brazen thieves made off with 18 paintings, jewelry, and figurines from the Montreal Museum of Fine Arts. The value today would be in the region of $10.9 million and included works from Delacroix, Gainsborough, and Rembrandt. Only one painting was returned and the rest have never been recovered. Three robbers gained access through a skylight that was being repaired and pulled the robbery off over Labor Day weekend when most people were away. It's believed to have been an inside job. Wild at art. At around 5 a.m. on December 20th, 2007, three robbers entered the Sao Paulo Museum of Art and stole two paintings. These were the Portrait of Suzanne Bloch by Pablo Picasso and Candido Portinari's O Lavrador de Café. They pulled this off within 3 minutes, and the artwork was missing until January 2008. They were undamaged and returned to the museum. While we're on the topic of art, does anyone have a favorite artist? Let us know in the comments below. 1. A man and his art. John Mark Tillman had quite the reputation. He was being investigated by Interpol, FBI, RCMP, and the US Department of Homeland Security as he had stolen over 10,000 pieces of artwork. It took authorities 3 years to crack the case and have him sentenced to 9 years in prison. Tillman, along with his Russian wife, would pose as security or maintenance workers and gain access to museums. They pilfered the art over 20 years, which included a 5,000-year-old Egyptian mummy. They also stole one of the most valuable books ever printed, a first edition of Charles Darwin's On the Origin of Species, which was 150 years old. In 2018, Tillman had signed a book and movie deal, but died unexpectedly on the 23rd of December the same year.